Welcome to today's lecture. This is the fourth lecture on wool, and the today's topic is properties of wool. In earlier lecture, briefly I have discussed about some of the important quality parameters of wool, like fiber diameter, fiber length, crimpiness, modulation. Those are very important for quality evaluation and grading. But now we are going to understand some of the more details properties of wool, like physical properties, chemical properties, and some mechanical properties. Here we will also discuss about the properties of other fibers like mohair or angora, and little bit about the properties of yarn and fabric also. Physical properties of wool. In general, wool is non-inflammable and not melt like most artificial fibers. So this won't catch fire easily or burn easily, and it won't melt easily like other fibers with heat. It has unique property of giving out heat when it absorbs water. So the wool, when it is kept on water, if it absorbs, it will give out some amount of heat. In fact, all textile fibers are hygroscopic and evolve heat when it is wet. Major physical properties of wool. So now we will see a series of physical properties in case of wool and other fiber. Number one is the color. The color of wool fiber could be white, near white, brown, and black. As I said earlier when I was discussing about the glossary, so all other color except white is generally termed as black wool in the industry. Number two, tensile strength, that is the ability to withstand some power against the fibers. So this tensile strength of wool in dry condition is 1 to 1.7 and in wet condition this is 0.8 to 1.6. Number three, elongation at break. That means up to what extent we can elongate it before it breaks. So this is, we can say, sometimes stretchability. So standard elongation is 25 to 30% the length, and 25 to 50% in wet condition. Number four, elastic recovery. This means to what extent we can stretch it and it can come back to normal. That is elastic recovery, that is quite good in case of wool than other fibers. Number five, specific gravity. So specific gravity indicates actually the relative density. That is, if density is converted as specific gravity, that is the weight per unit volume. So in case of wool, the specific gravity is 1.3 to 1.32. Further, other physical properties of wool and fibers. Number six is moisture regain, that is how much percent of moisture it can get back. The standard moisture regain is about 16 to 18%. Number seven, resiliency. This is an important characteristic related to the last chapter, I can say. So resilience, it is quite excellent in case of wool fiber. Number eight, refractive index. This is a property about reflection of light, which is measured with a specific refractometer, and that varies between 1.553 to 1.555. The number nine, luster. This I have already discussed earlier section when I was talking about the structure and quality of wool. So this depends on the fiber surface, size, and straightness of the fiber. So this gives the a glazy look of the fiber, it indicates. And number 10, fleece density. This is of course little different thing. This indicates the number of fibers per unit area on the skin, and which is determined by SP ratio. So in case of very high quality breed like Merino, this flies density is very high. I have already listed out some of the important physical properties of wool. Now we will discuss little details, some of the properties. Here it is about specific gravity and refractive index. The specific gravity of dry non-medulated wool is normally determined in benzene, and the value is about 1.304. These wool fibers have an oriented molecular structure and they are birefringent. So wool molecule, as I have discussed earlier about the orientation of the molecule in the cortex, that is the orthocele and paracele, they are having two different kind of arrangements. So naturally they have two different kind of refractive index, and that is called birefringent. So they have different refractive indexes for light vibrating in a plane parallel to the fiber axis, and for that vibrating transverse to the fiber axis. So when the light is parallel to the fiber, that time we will get a value of refractive index, but when the light is on the transverse to the fiber, we will have a different refractive index. So the refractive index along the fiber is 1.553 to 1.555, and that across the fiber is 1.542 to 1.546. Effect of heat on wool fiber. Wool becomes harsh at 100 degrees Celsius and begins to decompose at 120 degrees Celsius. It softens when heated or treated with boiling water for long time. It will scorch at 204 degrees Celsius and char at 300 degrees Celsius. Wool fiber does not burn freely when touched by flame and stops burning when it is removed from the fiber fire. So normally wool will not burn easily, and if you take it away from the fire, it will not burn anymore. So wool is self extinguishing and does not support combustion. So that's why many times the blankets are used for stopping the fire. If somebody catching fire is covered with blankets, and the fire can be very quickly stopped. Now, action of water on wool. Wool is neither soluble in cold nor hot water. Wool softens and loses strength on soaking in cold water and also in hot water, but drying restores some of the properties, or to a major extent in case of cold water, but in hot water means slightly it may affect. That's why the woolen garment should not be washed in hot water. Breaking up of wool macromolecules occur on continued boiling with water, causing decomposition. So if we keep the wool in boiling water for a long time, it may cause breaking up wool by decomposition. Wool acquires increased affinity for dyes on exposure to steam at high temperature. So if we expose wool at high temperature or steam, then it can pick up the dye, that is the color, better. Now about chemical properties of wool and fibers. The first one is effect of acids. Generally, wool is resistant to mineral acids even at high temperature, though nitric acid tend to cause damage by oxidation. Wool is attacked by hot concentrated sulfuric acid and decomposes completely. So if we use concentrated sulfuric acid and heat it at a high temperature, then it causes decomposition of the wool fiber. Sulfuric acid is used to remove vegetable matter in the carbonizing process. That is to remove the vegetable matters, which we are going to discuss in the section of wool processing. No harm occurs to wool in cold or boiling, but diluted mineral acids. So if the acids are diluted, then even boiling also will not cause any harm to the wool fiber. Wool absorbs acids and not removable by water wash, as the amino group in wool holds the acid. So once we put acid with the wool, the inner molecules or amino groups will absorb or hold the acid, so it cannot be removed by washing. Wool acquires more affinity for acid dyes, but decreases its basic dye affinity when treated with acid, especially sulfuric acid. So if the wool is treated with sulfuric acid, it will have a more affinity for acidic dyes, but the affinity for basic dye will reduce. So now, in continuation with chemical properties, number two is effect of alkalis. The chemical nature of wool keratin is such that it is particularly sensitive to alkalis. The major component of wool fiber is the keratin, and it is very sensitive to alkalis. Complete dissolution of wool occurs when boiled with 5% KOH solution for few minutes, because amino group breaks and amino acid reforms as a result of hydrolysis. So this you might have seen, it is used in case of skin scrapings, where the scrappings are heated with KOH solution. But in this case, if it is heated or boiled for a long time, then it causes damage to the wool fiber or the breakdown of the amino groups. The dilute solution of ammonia does not harm wool, though it is a strong alkali, but concentrated solution at higher temperature harms wool. So concentrated solution of ammonia at a higher temperature can cause harm to the wool fiber. Further, in continuation to chemical properties, number three is effect of organic solvent. Wool not affected in organic solvent, that is the methanol, ethanol, acetone, all these kind of organic solvents, nothing will happen to wool, or wool will not be getting affected. Number four is dyeing ability, that is the coloring is done for the wool to make the garments or clothes. So wool fiber could be dyed by basic dye, direct dye and acidic dye, although all the wool fiber is not same in characteristics. So this characteristic depends on the type of wool or the origin of the wool. It is the kind of breed of the sheep and the country of origin. So when we select wool fiber, we need to ascertain about the physical and chemical properties of wool. So wool, when it is taken for processing to make garments or clothing, we must know about their physical and chemical properties, because many factors can cause damage to these properties. Now, number three is the mechanical properties of wool. So there is a method called differential scanning calorimetry, DSC method, which is applied to determine the denaturation and degradation of wool fiber. That is how the mechanical properties are assessed. With increasing temperature, the tensile properties and durability of wool fibers decrease considerably. That means if we increase the temperature, then the tensile property, that is the weight bearing capacity, stretchability and the durability will decrease. Similarly, a great decrease on tensile properties was seen at temperature above 200 degrees Celsius, after which a denaturation of alpha keratin. So alpha keratin is like a helix, which I have discussed earlier in the microstructure of wool fiber, and a thermal degradation were observed in DSC diagram. So when the temperature goes beyond 200 degree, there is a denaturation in alpha keratin and further degradation observed, leading to the changes in the mechanical properties of the wool fiber. Here is some interesting mechanical properties found through research. The wet fibers have lower tensile characteristics except breaking extension, which increased by 9% and 20% for the fibers kept in water for 1 hour and 1 month respectively. That is, the tensile strength etc. get affected, but the breaking extension that get increased when we keep the fiber in water for 1 hour by 9% and 20% when it is kept for 1 month. Similarly, in another observation, the breaking extension of the fiber tested in water, that is within the water, if we do this, then there is a increase by 73% in the breaking extension. So that indicates the important role of water molecules on the intermolecular interactions during the stretching. So this indicates about the stretchability or tensile strength, which is very high when it is done within the water. Now we will understand about the physicochemical properties of mohair, that is the fiber coming from the angora goat, and little more about the other fibers like angora coming from rabbits, and the Kashmiri or Pashmina from the other goats, and little bit the properties about the yarn and the fabric. Much of the commercially available mohair is grown by mature breeding does and falls into the range of 34 to 38 micrometer. Angora wethers constitute another important source of mohair, which will be coarser than that from does. Fineness is the dominant characteristic affecting manufacturing value and price, which we have already learned earlier. In case of wool fiber or all other natural fiber, the diameter is very, very important for its utility in manufacturing the clothes or garments or apparel. So that is the fineness. The average diameter is the sole basis for grading to mohair. So mohair fiber also grading is done the majorly based on diameter of the fiber. Physicochemical properties of mohair. The surface of mohair resembles that of wool of corresponding diameter. So if we take the same diameter, the surface of mohair is almost similar to wool. However, the epidermal scales of mohair tend to protrude and overlap less than those of wool, thus contributing to a relatively smooth handle. The feeling of touch by hand, that is the handle, it is better in case of mohair due to the less protrusion of the scales at the cuticle layer and less overlapping of the scales. The greater light is reflected from mohair than from Kashmiri and wool, providing it characteristic luster. So the luster is better in case of mohair due to greater light reflection, because it is a property of light reflection, and it is better than the Kashmiri fiber, that is Pashmina or the wool fiber. The cross section of mohair has a high degree of circularity with contour ratio of rarely exceeding 1:1.2. That means it is more round, the fibers, that is the more circularity, and when it is more round, then the ratio of the higher, greater and the lesser diameter will be less. So this is having more circular fiber. And finally, heavily modulated coarse mohair, that is also could be kemp, contain a collapsed medulla, does appear markedly elliptical. So that means if the diameter is very high, in that case it will not be circular, rather more elliptical. Now about frictional properties of mohair. Mohair differs from wool in frictional properties, so it has got more frictional behavior. The friction of waxed mohair with wool as a blended yarns increased with increasing mohair content. That means in a blend of yarn with mohair and wool, if the mohair portion is increased, the friction also increases. By scouring or extracting the yarns with a solvent prior to waxing, the yarn friction can be reduced. So this friction can be reduced by scouring, that is the cleaning and washing properly, which we are going to learn in the processing section, or by extracting the yarns with solvent, we can reduce this yarn friction. Now next is about burning behavior, which we have already discussed in case of wool. As I said, it won't catch fire easily and it stops burning once it is taken away from the fire. But in case of cotton and viscose rayon, they are easily ignited, they burn rapidly and are difficult to extinguish. So the burning material form a fragile ash, whereas in case of wool fiber, it won't form a fragile ash. So these fibers can be treated to improve their burning behavior, but some of the desirable properties of the fabric are affected. So these nets, cotton and viscose, we can mix with this mohair or this woolen fiber to prevent their burning or improve their burning behavior, but some of the properties of the fabric will be affected. Now there is a property like wettability, that is how much it get wet easily with the water. The surface of Kashmiri, that is pashmina, is more hydrophilic than wool, leading to ease of wettability, that is the Kashmiri fiber or pashmina get easily wet with the water. If paraffin oil added to both wool and Kashmiri and then scoured in soap solutions, the wool retain more oil than the Kashmiri because Kashmiri is more hydrophilic than the wool. So the nature of Kashmiri has got to easily wet, so it cannot retain the oil, whereas the wool fiber is more of hydrophobic, so it retains more of the oil. So this property, Kashmiri had more of the polar amino acids, that is serine, threonine and tyrosine, than the wool. So these amino acids are having more polar property. Because of that, these fiber like Kashmiri or pashmina has got more hydrophilic property, so they get wet easily or more wettability than the wool fiber. Now another important property, that is dyeability, that is ability to catch the dye for coloring. So there was an experiment done with wool and Kashmiri dyed with chiton red G and methylene blue respectively. Two different dyes were used in case of Kashmiri and the other pure wool. Kashmiri and wool uptake dye 60% and 40% respectively when the two fibers dyed under same condition. So under same condition, Kashmiri took 60% dye whereas wool took 40%. The dyeing of the Kashmiri was more patchy than the wool. The unevenness of the staining on Kashmiri was due to the epicuticle of Kashmiri is more porous than that of wool. That is the outer structure. In the cuticle, there are three layers. One of the important layer is the epicuticle, that is the outer one, which is more porous. That means the dye easily goes inside and it takes more dye and more patchy. The next important property is thermal insulation. So that is the most important reason for using the woolen garments. So warmth is the most common reason for wearing woolen knitwear, and that is about 31%, suggesting the importance of winter apparel as a market for specialty fibers. So these fibers, woolen or other specialty fiber, that gives a special warmth, and that's why it has so much of demand as a winter garments. Now the thermal resistance of a fabric depends on the amount of entrapped air. So the air is entrapped between the fiber and that gives the warmth. So fine specialty fibers and the furry surface of mohair needs is advantageous. So these fine fibers, or in case of mohair, they has the specialty to hold more air and that gives the more warmth, and that's how they are very much popular and demand. Yarn properties. especially for mohair. So far we were discussing about the fiber properties. Now it is about the yarn. The hairiness of mohair yarns is an interesting property. Hairiness is an asset enhancing the appearance of the fabric, especially hand knitted. That is, the hand knitted apparels will have a special appearance due to the hairiness of the mohair fiber. For this purpose, brushing of mohair yarns and fabrics is common in the industry. So all the yarns or fabrics prepared from mohair fiber is being brushed for improving this appearance. Friction is another very important property of yarns destined for machine knitting. So whatever machine knitting is done, in that case the friction behavior is very, very important. This is an important property of the fiber. It determines knitting efficiency, yarn breakage and stitch length. So if the friction is more, it will have an impact on the knitting efficiency or breakage and the length. So to improve this friction behavior, the paraffin wax is used. Paraffin wax is effective in reducing yarn friction, but its efficacy affected by excessive processing oils and additives. So at the preliminary stage of wool processing, the oils are used to prevent the entangling of the individual fibers. So that comes into the way. Otherwise, paraffin wax can help in reducing the friction and thereby help in better knitting efficiency. Now we will learn about the fabric properties. Kashmiri and superfine wool of similar length and diameter showed differences in processing behavior and fabric properties. So when it is compared with the same diameter and length between fine wool and Kashmiri, there is a lot of difference in their processing behavior and fabric properties. The outstanding difference in processing was the low fiber cohesion by Kashmiri fiber. So Kashmiri fiber, though it is equally fine, but they have low cohesion, which affect the processing behavior. During fabric finishing, the Kashmiri fabric shrink very little compared to the woolen fabric. So the fabric shrinking is more with the Kashmiri fiber, probably due to fewer strains imposed and subsequently released in the Kashmiri yarn during finishing. So when we do the finishing, that time there is a strains imposed, but it is released subsequently, so there is a less shrink in the fabric made with Kashmiri fiber. And the next is low cohesion and shrinkage of Kashmiri is due to its low crimp. As I mentioned earlier, crimpiness, that is the waviness of the wool, which is more in case of fine wool fiber, and that is mainly due to the bilateral arrangement of the ortho and para cortical cells. So that causes the less crimp, and also due to the low frictional properties. So these pashmina or Kashmiri, they have got low crimp and low frictional properties. Hence, they have low cohesion and shrinkage of the fabric. In continuation to fabric properties, in earlier days, mohair was mainly used in textiles that should be highly durable. That is, the materials or fabrics which need to be very strong. In such materials only mohair was used due to its strong properties. In blends with wool, finer grades of mohair are used to produce lightweight suitings. So sometimes mohair is mixed with wool to produce a lightweight settings and suitings. Similarly, mohair can be dyed to very light bright shades while retaining its natural luster. As I told earlier, the mohair has got very good luster, and the advantage is it can be given a dark color dye without even affecting the luster. So these attributes are used to produce attractive dress materials like shawls, stoles and various other women's wear. So this is how the fabrics can be made using the mohair. So now we are at the end of today's lecture. So we discussed that today's topic was the properties of wool. I will just summarize. First, we discussed about the physical properties, then chemical properties, then mechanical properties, mainly about wool fibers. And then we have discussed a little bit about the properties of mohair and Kashmiri in comparison to wool. So this is as per the syllabus, mostly for the undergraduate students. Some more details you can learn from the lecture notes given or from my book. And there are a lot of procedures or machineries and instruments involved in measuring all these properties, which I am not discussing here and not required for the undergraduates. For the postgraduate students, I am going to discuss separately. So hope it is easy to learn. Thank you for listening.